Hello students and welcome back. Today's video is for class A and this is a continuation of the same chapter that we were doing last, Coming Home to Delhi by Madhur Jaffe. In the last video, we learned about the entire story that she has written. We summarized, we understood the different things that she has told as narrator to us in her lesson. Today we will look into the different elements that she has used in her lesson or writing. Madhur Jaffe was born on 13th August 1933. She is a well-known actor as well as a writer of cookbook and an expert in Indian, Asian and world vegetarian cuisine. She won several awards, one of them is James Beard Foundation Award. Now in her writing, especially in Coming Home to Delhi, which is an autobiography, she focuses on her memory of childhood in Delhi with glimpses of life of an anglicized Indian family. The story is a narration of the early life in colonial period, that is from 1930s to 1940s. Coming Home to Delhi is an extract from A Taste of India, where the author has described about multiple cuisine and her experience through the journey of being where she is. Now, the two most important elements that Madhur Jaffe has used in her writing is social, cultural and historical context as well as nostalgia. Now, let us understand how she has used it with reference to the text. Social, cultural and historical concept that she has used is because of the place she was born in, that is Delhi. Now she was emotionally very attached to this place. She has deep feelings of affection for Delhi. She says that it is the place where she was born, where her ancestors lived. It is a really a combination of many Delhis. May various rulers came and ruled over Delhi, but the most glorious ones that she refers to is the Mughals. The Mughals conquered Delhi and they came up with various monuments, structures, they brought in different types of cuisine. They made their cuisine as the local food of Delhi. Also, there were various gardens that they came up with. The Mughals contributed to Delhi in varied culture by building two cities, Shahjahanabad, which is called as the Old City. The Old City or Shahjahanabad is well known as much as the Mughals were. Furthermore, the Mughals built gardens, water tanks, canals of marble that went through places. That was from bedroom to the kitchen. They furnished every house with marbles. They greatly influenced Delhi's dishes, as the Persian style pulao was also one of those dishes that were considered as the staple or the local food of Delhi, which was brought in by the Mughals. Meat, samosas, pakoras, teas added to the delicacies of the city's local food. Now, like I said, they were very famous during that period, the colonial period. The Mughals ruled Delhi, but they were remembered for a long, long time. It was not like the other rulers who ruled and brought in a lot of destruction, but Mughals were those during that age who brought in lot of changes, good changes, which are still cherished by the people living in Delhi. Now let's move on to the next element, that is nostalgia. Now if you have read the lesson, you might have noticed the lesson begins with the train journey that Madhur Jaffe along with her family is going through. They have gone to the hill station during vacation and are coming back in the train to Delhi. And on her way, what she notices is the tea vendor who comes in with terracotta cups to give tea, to sell tea. Now these awaken a lot of memories in her mind. She also comes up with the thought of the Yamuna River and the belief that was associated with Yamuna River. That is, the tradition that was followed, people would take a bundle of coins or a bunch of coins in their hand and they would throw it in Yamuna River. And it was believed that if the coin hit the river, then they would be blessed. Whereas if the coin hit the washerman washing clothes at the bank of the river, then they would not be blessed. She also tells us about the food that they ate during that time, especially kebabs. Kebabs were like the most important delicacy during that time that people cherished. Also, pakoras, samosas, puris, these were kind of food that they ate during that time. Women were not given too much liberty, but Madhu Jaffrey do narrates to us, women were not given much freedom during that time, but she narrates to us one incident about women playing tennis in the courtyard with their saris and tennis shoes, and the courtyard was empty and no one would see them playing tennis. She also narrates about the time when they would sit in the evening around their grandfather, who would narrate to them or tell them folk stories about history, about how history came up to what it is, the culture of history, the food tradition of history. So he would give lectures to them on the folk stories or the history of Delhi. Another important thing that she mentions to us is the preparation for family picnics. Now, the most important episode that she discusses or she narrates to us is a family picnic. They would get up early in the morning, prepare food and rush for picnic. Now, while they were going also, they had a different pattern that they followed. There were only four vehicles and there would be 30 people fitting into those vehicles and going to the picnic spot. They would go to Qutub Minar or mostly the historical places of Delhi, and they would have a lot of fun. Now they were almost 30 people in the family and they would enjoy each and every moment together, going for picnics, whether it's narrating stories or playing dhamsharas or antaksharis. This is what they would do during their leisure time. So these were the two elements that Madhu Jaffrey has emphasized upon in the entire lesson. One is the social, cultural and historical context, and the other one is nostalgia. Students, I hope you have understood the lesson and these two elements that Madhu Jaffrey is trying to convey to us or picturize before us. Moving ahead, I have a homework for you. Given your four questions, which I want you to solve, answer them in around 100 to 150 words each. You can refer to your textbook and answer these questions. Thank you.